Hello, everyone. Welcome to this presentation about equation for a rational function that passes through given points based on divided differences. I would like to start from stating that there is a perfectly good way to do this, to find a rational function that passes through a number of points. For example, as explained here at a rational interpolation page of help of Maple, to make a rational function to pass through points x0, y0, x1, y1, and so on, it's required to solve a system of linear equations, like encircled with this ellipse here. Or, as explained better on the next slide, to make a rational function, which is a ratio of two polynomials of order n and m, as we will refer further, order n, m, it's required to solve a system of equations R and m dependent on zk is equal to omega k for k running through p points. And these equations lead to a system of linear equations for coefficients b and c. So what we are going to do in this presentation, we will solve the same problem in a different way, in a way that final result will have a more intuitive and simple structure than a general solution to a system of linear equations. And this final result will look a kind of similar to a Newton polynomial. Yeah? And there will be other advantages there. For example, it will be possible to increase or decrease the order of the numerator or denominator without a need to recalculate the entire solution of the linear equations all over again. So let's have a look quickly on the overview of this presentation. First, we will consider a Newton polynomial, which is a rational function with order of the numerator n and order of the denominator 0, passing through n plus 1 points. Then we will discuss a ratio of two linear functions, basically a rational function with order 1, 1, passing through 3 points. Then the case of orders of the numerator and denominator equal, and then more general cases. And we will also consider a numerical example with number of points equal to 6 to test how the derived equation works. So the case of n0 on Newton polynomial is very well known. It can be written in different ways, also as illustrated on this slide. And to be short, the coefficients, which are named here delta, are chosen in a way that for z equals z1, the expression takes value omega 1. For z equals z2, expression takes value omega 2, and so on and so on. So what are we going to do further? We will change the structure of this equation and the definition of the divided differences in a way that it will be possible to address the cases of n minus 1, 1, n minus 2, 2, and so on, not only n0. So let's have a look on a ratio of two linear functions. If such simple rational function is passing through 3 points, it can be written down as equation here, omega 1 plus z minus z1 over z2 minus z1, omega 2 minus omega 1, and so on. And if we have a look on this expression, we will find that this parts of it, this one, and this one, encircled with an ellipse, those three expressions are suspiciously similar to divided differences. Yeah. So they look like divided differences defined upside down, so that the difference of the arguments is on the top, and the difference of the divided differences is on the bottom. So it's something like this equation below, described through three divided differences, but kind of inverse divided differences. And indeed, this expression can be generalized into a longer continued fraction like this that acts in a way similar to a Newton polynomial. And apparently, this continued fraction equation is also known in literature, for example, in reference one. And it basically works in a similar way to Newton polynomial. It makes omega z to take values, to take p values of omega 1, omega 2, and so on at p argument points. Yeah. However, if we convert this expression into its canonical form like this, we will find that yes, it takes p prescribed values at p points. However, the order of the numerator is either equal to the order of the denominator or is equal to m plus one. So we don't have really a control over the order of the numerator and denominator. They all are equal or close to each other. Yeah. So what we can do as a next step, we will write down the Newton polynomial equation as a diagram here on the left, and the staircase part representing continued fraction equation on the right, and we will stitch them together in a way like this. Here we go. So the equation will go k steps along the Newton polynomial equation, and then it will go down and down on the staircase structure along the continued fraction. And the result will look like this. Instead of stopping right here at this delta k, k plus one, as it would be for a Newton polynomial, we will continue on and on with continuous fraction. Yeah. And this, and in this way, we could realize the function that takes omega one, omega two, and so on up to p at p values of the argument. Yeah. However, for this, we will have to change also definition of the divided differences, which will be different for higher order differences and for the lower order differences. Yeah. Yeah. So basically, at this point, instead of stopping at this encircled expression, we are adding the entire continued fraction, and the entire continued fraction will provide proper values of this denominator to make the expression take values zk at take values omega k at values zk. So this is a very interesting equation, and it's also interesting in relation to other rational function equations. For example, in this literature sources 1-3, we can find that it's possible to write down a generalized equation for rational interpolation, so-called barycentric interpolation equation, which is a kind of analog of Lagrange polynomial approach for rational functions. Maybe it's also possible to derive something like analog of Newton polynomial for rational functions, like a general case of rational functions by combining polynomial structure, continued fraction, and something else. So coming back to this equation, let's select p equal to 6 So n plus m will be 5 then. And let's generate all those rational functions. Yeah. So by taking k in this equation equal to 1, 3, and 5, we will be able to generate three different rational functions as given further on the next slide. So for k equal 5, when the expression goes as a Newton polynomial up to the end, we will have basically a function of the order 5,0 or a polynomial. When k is equal to 3, when the staircase part starts earlier, we will get a rational function of the order 4,1. And finally, for k equal 1, when the staircase starts almost immediately at the beginning of the equation, we will have a rational function of the order of 3,2. Yeah. So we will choose a numerical values for zk and omega k to put into the equation and calculate the result and plot. Unfortunately, the equation from the previous slide cannot give functions with orders of the denominator higher than the order of the numerator. So that's not possible by the structure of this equation. So to generate those with order of the denominator higher, we will just use inverse function that takes inverse values and use the same equations. Yeah. So that's why I also specify here inverse values 1 over omega k. Yeah. Unfortunately, one of the rational function values omega is 0. So to make everything work, I will put 1 over epsilon here. Let's see how that will work out. For k equal 5, we get a simple polynomial R5,0. For k equal 3, we get a rational function of the order 4,1, and for k equal 1, we get a rational function of the order 3,2. So this works as expected. And if we plot all those together on one graph, well, it seems they do what they have to do. They pass through 6 defined points. Now to calculate inverse functions that take inverse values and setting epsilon going to 0, we could still calculate R2,3 and R1,4, but however, not R0,5, because then the limit does not exist, and no wonder that the system does not calculate a limit to that with epsilon equal to 0, because inverse polynomial, or the case 0,5, cannot take 0 value at finite point. Eh? So inverse polynomial cannot take 0 values at finite points. So it will not work like that. Yeah? So just to plot the curve, I will put epsilon very small, just for the purpose of plotting the curve. Yeah, so as we see here, the other three functions with order of the denominator higher than the order of the numerator also work as expected. They pass through those 6 points. So far we discussed only one type of staircase equation, which is k steps along the polynomial structure, and then step by step down along the staircase structure with a continued fraction. Yeah, and that corresponds to this equation below. Yeah. However, other kind of structures are possible. It's possible to integrate a piece of the polynomial, then do one step into continued fraction, and then still continue as a polynomial, and that is given by expression below. However, now there is no guarantee that the sum of the order of the denominator and the numerator plus one will be equal to the number of points. In other way around, for p points, we will have order sum of the orders of the polynomial in the numerator and denominator higher than in the previous case. Yeah. And who knows what interesting properties other structures can have, maybe something like this. So that's indeed an issue worth investigating. Yeah. So to summarize, it's possible to integrate the Newton polynomial equation with additional continued fraction part to model rational functions of the order nm, n being greater or equal than m, that pass through p points, which is n plus one. So not only polynomials, the case of p minus one, zero, but yeah, but basically all rational functions for which n plus one is equal to p. Yeah, and to do this, divided differences have to be redefined in a piecewise way depending on their order. And the structure has to be slightly changed, the structure of the polynomial, but it works. And it's the general case of the staircase-like equation may be worth investigating. It's the case where number of points is allowed to be less than n plus one, or other way around, the orders of the numerator and denominator together are allowed to be larger, n plus m is allowed to be larger than number of points minus one. Yeah, so who knows what interesting properties those rational functions can have. Yeah. So this is the end of the presentation, and thank you for your attention.